الله أكبر.
He created the universe. To him belong the heavens and the earth. The ever living, he is the first. He's the owner and redeemer. He them his messengers to warn his creatures of the great. He created the universe. To him belong the heavens and the earth. The ever living.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله ما شاء الله. إن شاء الله تعالى we are going to study together an important topic which is about the tawheed, believing the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without associating any partner with him, whether that partner happened to be a messenger or a prophet, or a saint, any object that is worshipped. The only deity that deserves to be worshipped is Allah Azza wa Jal. And for that very reason, he created us. So the Tawheed, my dear brothers and sisters, and dear viewers, wherever you are, is the key of paradise. No Tawheed, no paradise. Only the monotheist, those who worship Allah alone, will be granted the Jannah. So unless we actualize and bring the Tawheed in our life, there will not be salvation. So inshallah, we hope by the grace of Allah, this topic will be beneficial to everyone inshallah. So for the coming few days inshallah, we'll be together studying a beautiful book on this topic. Inshallah.
He created the universe. To him belong the heavens and the earth.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, our topic is the Tawheed, Kitab al-Tawheed, a beautiful book on this important topic. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward the author immensely. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him the highest level in the Jannah. Ameen. And this book addresses one aspect of the Tawheed. Because now we know the meaning of Tawheed, which means to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or believe in his oneness. And the Tawheed, lexically or according to the dictionary definition, it is a verbal noun, which we call it in Arabic masdar, derived from the root wahada, waw, ha, dal. So wahada yuwahidu tawheedan. Are you following? Where the name came, it is the verbal noun, which means to unite, unify, put together. For instance, an Arab would say, وَحَّدَ الْمَلِكُ الْبِلَادَ. The king has brought together the whole different states of the country, or unified the country. There were different states, he brought them together. So that is from the linguistic perspective. And always there will be a relationship between the lexical meaning, the linguistic one, and the technical one. There will be always a relationship. So now, what is the definition of Tawheed technically from the perspective of the Muslims theologians? How the Muslim theologians define the Tawheed? They said the Tawheed, it is to single out Allah with respect to His essence, His person, His names and divine attributes, and also to single Him out with respect to our own deeds. So we have three aspects of the Tawheed, or three categories of Tawheed. Are you following? One aspect, it talks about the person of Allah Himself, that the essence of Allah. How is Allah? Who is Allah? And the other aspect about His beautiful names, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third, about us, the human beings, that we have to worship Him and Him alone. So singling out Allah regarding His person, His essence, this is called Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, unity of Lordship. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah is singling out Allah with respect to His person. Is this clear? With respect to His person, that He is unique. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. So this is called unity of Lordship, or Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Is this clear? Then singling Him out with respect to His beautiful names and divine attributes. And this is called Tawheed al-Asma wa-Sifat, unity of divine names and attributes of Allah. Tawheed al-Asma wa-Sifat, that His names are unique. His attributes are unique. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Nothing is like unto Him, and He is all-seer, all-hearer. So His names are different than our names. His names, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah's names are the most beautiful names. And Allah's names, they have meanings. They have what? Meanings. So we believe in His beautiful names, and the meanings of the names, and the meaning of the name is the attribute. Are you following? The meaning of the name is what? The attribute. So that is Tawheed al-Asma wa-Sifat. Then we have another aspect, which is called Tawheed al-Ibadah, or Tawheed al-Uluhiyah, or unity of worship. And that is applied to us, which means singling out Allah with respect to our own deeds. Our own deeds. Whereas Rububiyyah, singling Him out with respect to His own actions. The actions of Allah that He creates, He provides, He cherishes. So He's the provider, cherisher, etc. That is Rububiyyah. Whereas the Uluhiyyah, or unity of worship, that we offer all our acts of worship to whom? Allah and Allah only. Is this clear? Now, this whole book is about unity of worship. It's only talking about the unity of worship. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. What is Uluhiyyah? Uluhiyyah is an Arabic word from the root. Aliha. يَأْلَهُ إِلَاهَةً أَلِهَا يَأْلَهُ إِلَاهَةً means to worship. حَبَدَ يَعْبُدُ عِبَادَةً. That's the meaning of it. So أَلِهَا in Arabic means to worship. So أُلُوهِيَّة is the worship. That's why he's called إِلَاه, which means مَعْبُود, worship, the one whom you worship. Are you following? So now this book, my dear brothers and sisters, is talking about the unity of ibadah, worship. And you will be surprised that the three types of tawheed mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. All the three types of tawheed mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Rabb, you see, the Rabb, Rububiyyah. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Asma and Sifat, the most merciful, the most compassionate. Asma and Sifat, unity of divine names and the attribute. Maliki Yawm al-Din, owner, which one? Rububiyyah. He's the Rabb, he's the owner of that day. Then, Iyaka na'budu, Iyaka nasta'in is Uluhiyyah. We worship only you. So all the three types of the Tawheed mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha.
Dear brothers and dear sisters and dear viewers, stay tuned. We'll be back inshallah after a short break.